Okay, I'm going to construct a perpendicular bisector of a segment. Now, first thing, I need to draw a segment. So I'm going to make a point A here, and then just draw a segment to right there, let's say, and that's point B. Now I'm going to make the perpendicular bisector of this segment. So I'm going to take my compass, and I'm going to make it more than halfway. So the midpoint of segment AB would be roughly here. I'm going to take my compass and make it, I don't know, roughly two-thirds of the total distance, something like that. Then I'm just going to make an arc. Okay, like that. Then, without changing the size of the compass or the measure of the compass, I'm going to put the pointy end on point A and make another arc. Like that. So you end up with this kind of football shape here. But the important thing is this point here and here. I'll call this point C and this point D. Now with our compass, we measured that distance from B to C is the same as the distance from B to D, but it's also the same as the distance from A to C and the distance from A to D. Now the thing is, if you have a point that is not on a line segment and it is equidistant to the end points, meaning the same distance, it has to be on the perpendicular bisector. So point C has to be on the perpendicular bisector, so does point D. And since two points determine a line, we can draw that line. Okay? So we can say this line CD is the perpendicular bisector of AB. Also notice that point A is a reflection of point B and vice versa. And because you have a reflection situation here, let's call this point P here in the middle. This distance from A to P is the same distance as the distance from B to P. Okay. So this perpendicular bisector is very interesting. There's a lot of equidistance going on. Any point on this perpendicular bisector is equidistant from point A and point B. So if I were to pick another point up here, let's call this point E. Let's just measure with a compass and see. Now it should be the same distance from BE to AE. So there's BE, it's measured out. Now let's compare with AE. Exact same distance. And this point E is on the perpendicular bisector also. So that is how you construct a perpendicular bisector.